What's going on, guys? Briar Rabbit here. Quick video about the Ace of Spades quest. In the background of this video, you can actually see all of the Cade Stash locations. The third or fourth part of the quest asks you to go find Cade Stashes on four random locations, or not random, four locations in the Destiny universe. They're always the same. They're the same for every player. So you can just follow the guide in the video in the background. It shows you exactly where I loaded in and then exactly where I went. The one exception to this is the one you're watching now. I went a little further in just because it was a very long drive for where I spawned in. You can get to this location by going to the Arms Dealer Strike or by just going to patrol and go into this area. It's not too hard to find once you know where it is, but it is a tricky one because it's a little out of the way. There's no real reason to come over here. Now, normally you can see in the bottom left-hand corner, Cade Stash nearby does display when you're near a Cade Stash. That helps you find it, helps you know you're in the right place. But sometimes it can be a little tricky because it's behind a wall or it's above you or below you, and maybe there's a ceiling or a floor between you, but it still registers that it's nearby. So it can be a little tricky, but once you know the locations, it's not too hard to find them. And for the most part, you can just run right to them. You don't have to worry about fighting. You don't have to worry about doing any of that stuff. A couple of notes about the quest itself. I did like the quest overall. It was a little frustrating getting the Gambit kills. A couple tips about Gambit. You have to get 5 kills with a hand cannon on invaders in Gambit. So these have to be people that invade your area. You can't go into, you can't be the invader and go get 5 hand cannon kills. Makes it a little tough because most people who invade tend to invade with a power weapon like the Sleeper Simulant or the Ward of Coil. Or a super, so getting hand cannon kills can present a problem. It really helps to play with, you know, players, to play with a fire team so you can be calling out the invaders. I did it solo. It took a really long time because I had to find the invader, and then I had to kill him with a hand cannon while he's shooting at me with, like, a power weapon or a super. So, for me, this was the longest part of the quest, was the Gambit part of the quest. But, you know, there's other bounties for Gambit right now, so try and be as smart as you can about seeing what bounties you have and kind of combining different activities to get as much done as you can at once. The second part of the quest, I believe, was 25 headshot kills in the Crucible with a hand cannon. That didn't take too long. And then the next part was 250 kills with a hand cannon in strikes. Again, I think that took me 3 strikes to get finished up. Not that long. You do have to be a little more aggressive than you might be because there's a lot of people working on this quest right now. So a lot of people are trying to get those hand cannon kills in strikes. So you may have to compete with your teammates to get those kills. But for the most part, it was a fairly straightforward quest after the Gambit part. You have to come and find these chests. But again, this video hopefully will help you find those quickly and easily. The last part of the quest I don't want to talk about too much. It's a mission. It's a specific mission. There's some story in it, and I don't want to talk about the story at all. I will say that because of the story and because of the reward, the Ace of Spades, the fantastic exotic hand cannon that's finally going to get me to put down the Midnight Coup sometimes, you know, it's well worth your time to go and do this quest. It's a little bit laborious, but it is a very good hand cannon and has some really good story nuggets in the mission at the end. And similar to like the Gjallarhorn quest in Rise of Iron, there's some feels there too. You know, it kind of reminds you of times gone. It also talks about the future a little bit, and it's got some of that kind of Cade witticism that we all know and love. I'm going to miss Cade tremendously in Destiny. He's definitely been my favorite character in the game, and having him gone is definitely, it's bittersweet to say the least. It's definitely provided ample motivation for this DLC, for the story of this DLC. But losing Cade for the future definitely, you know, it kind of stinks a little bit. So the quest itself isn't so bad, like I said before. Really, the Gambit part is the one that took me the longest. To me, it helped to kind of stay in the back of the map when I knew that there was going to be an invader. Try and be on the opposite side of the map than where most of the PvE enemies are. That's where the invaders tend to spawn. And I try and be like right at the edge of the map, and hopefully the invader would spawn in front of me, start shooting my teammates, and then I could just shoot him in the back of the head with my hand cannon. That's what worked for me. It didn't win me any friends on my team, though, because I wasn't contributing to getting motes or anything. And like I said, when they invade with, you know, Ward of Coil, Supers, the Sleeper Simulant, it can be difficult to get those hand cannon kills because, you know, you're not getting into a whole lot of primary fights with invaders. Invaders tend to come in with high power weapons and are trying to get a job done as fast as possible. So getting hand cannon kills on them can be, it can be laborious. It really does help to go in with a fire team so you can be calling out the location of the invaders. Maybe have your teammates soften them up for you so you can finish them off with a hand cannon. That can really help as well, because, you know, like I said, you're at a disadvantage right at the get-go. He can see you, he knows exactly where you are. You don't know where he is, and he's probably using a better weapon than you are. That's just the fact of the matter. So it's a difficult part of that quest, but well worth it. So that's going to do it for this one, guys. Thank you very much for watching. If you like this video, hit the like button. If you're new to the channel, hit subscribe. If you got any tips on how to get those 5 kills in Gambit, definitely leave them in the comments below. People are really going to appreciate that one. It can be a laborious and a time-intensive task. Luckily, the 25 kills in the Crucible and the 250 kills in Strikes isn't too bad. So that's going to do it, guys. This is the last stash. Have a great day. We'll see you next time. Bye.